Good day, generals, and welcome back to another Call of War breakdown. So in this breakdown, we're going to be looking at the militia unit, when they're practical to use and when they are not, how strong they are, and just a general overview of how to use these units. Now, in the start of your campaigns, you will probably have a few of these units lying around because they are extremely cheap, extremely easy to produce. In fact, they only need a barracks in order to be produced. However, they are also the weakest unit in the game, relatively. The weakest ground unit, that is. Generally, they are vulnerable to almost all other units. Light tanks, infantry, planes, they generally have no strength against any of these. The only time they have strength is when attacking or defending from other militia units, or when bunched up into large divisions to produce a defensive line. Let's have a quick look at their statistics, and then we'll go over a few times that you can use these units for a defense or an attack, and what strategies you can implement. So you can see attacking infantry, these are their levels here. They generally do not have a strong attack on infantry. Another infantry's defense will generally outweigh a militia's attack. Strength defending from infantry is a bit better. Generally, they will be able to, when in a defensive position, especially if in a fortified position, they will be able to defend against infantry units, but I wouldn't count on it. Against armor, they are completely useless, and to throw a militia unit at an armor division is generally suicidal. Against the air, they have a very low defense rate, but it is okay to deter enemy fighters. However, from bombers, they are almost completely useless. When attacking buildings, this is important to note. When attacking buildings, they have a very low destruction rate, destructive strength. Now, this can be used to your advantage, but we'll get to that later. If we have a look at their speed, they are exceptionally slow at 15 kilometers per hour. That is 5 kilometers per hour less than a general infantry unit, and well below any mobile infantry, mechanized infantry, or tank divisions. Their health is only 15 units, which is pitiful, to say the least, and they're all unarmored. As I mentioned before, they are an infantry unit. They do have an advantage in the forest, quite a substantial advantage, with 75% increased strength. Now, that's good to keep in mind. The only time that I would recommend using these units in any capacity is if they're positioned in a forest, that also means dunes, position, and perhaps if they can use a fortified position too, so the creation of fortifications. So let's go over a few ways you can use these units to defend or attack, and what strategies to use. Generally, in an attack, they are very good for taking areas that your main front can't be diverted to. Say if your main front, your tanks and your infantry classes are heading towards the main enemy force, militia units are nice to pull in behind and capture any deserted provinces, and especially deserted cities. Because they have a very low destructive capacity on enemy buildings, they'll be able to capture infrastructure and industrial complexes without damaging them near as much as your other infantry classes, and especially your other armored classes would cause damage to. So they are good for capturing deserted provinces and making them able to produce more units for you by keeping the infrastructure. They're also good to mount a defense. If your main force is diverted on one front, these are good to keep in reserve on your other flanks, just to make sure that you can slow down the enemy if they cut through, or if they tried to flank you with a flanking maneuver. The only other time I'd use these is in extreme desperation. Basically, worst case scenario, if your armies have been completely overrun or are completely pinned down, you might consider producing militia units very quickly, very easily, to try to mount a counterattack or just defend your lost few provinces. Of course, that would be a last stand kind of maneuver. But it is good for that because they are cheap and easy to produce. You don't need a lot of resources, and you don't need a lot of time. So those are really the only times you would use militia units. Aside from that, I can't think of any other uses for them. They are pretty useless, but they can come in handy when you're in a desperate situation. So let me know what you think about the militia units. Perhaps I'm wrong, perhaps there are other uses for them. Comment down below, and don't forget to leave this video a like if you want to see more breakdowns of Call of War units and tactics.